This is the launch of the University of Southern California Rocket Propulsion Laboratory's rocket, Fireball. The terminal countdown begins now. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition. The space that we're in right now is the USC Rocket Propulsion Lab. We are the premier undergraduate rocketry team here at USC and also kind of considered that around the country because of our vehicle Traveler 4. That was the first vehicle that passed the Kármán line and made it to space.
Traveler 4 was a huge accomplishment for the club. Rocket Lab's founding goal was to send a rocket to space past the Kármán line, and Traveler 4 was the rocket to achieve that. After Traveler 4, we weren't just a rocket lab anymore. We were USC RPL. California knew about us, the country knew about us, the world knows about us. Students started to come to USC for Rocket Lab. But after Traveler 4 happened, internally, while the world was congratulating us on this achievement, Rocket Lab was almost having an identity crisis because we achieved this founding goal, and now we didn't really know what was to come next. And so after some long discussions, we were like, well, let's do it again.
Fireball is a project that was created for this year to be a high-performance vehicle that was geared at giving the students the opportunity to test out a lot of the new developments from Traveler 4 to get us into kind of the stage of being ready to start transferring things from a space shot to a space program.
Last year, we had a lot of failures. We go out and, Earth-shaky or Earth-shakiest, they blow up. I know this club can be more. This year we're kind of ramping it up. And I know that if this succeeds, we're gonna be on the path to success.
Biggest fear I have is we're out there and we do a countdown and we hit launch and it's looking good. And Lena, the avionics lead, comes to me and says that we don't have any power to the avionics unit. That thought keeps me up a lot.
It's not.
There's really not much about RPL that isn't special. We do everything in-house by hand. That does not happen at many other universities. Most people will buy their motor and will put it into a pre-made kit. We design everything from scratch. We do the analysis ourselves. We do the research. And then we actually go and we get the material. And if we don't have the right tooling to make the material into the rocket, we make the tooling ourselves. And it's something that will always set us apart and is why we're the premier rocketry team across the country. No one else has what we have. We are definitely not just a technical organization, we're also very social. And that shines through when you come to build hours or when you come to build events. You can pretty clearly see that.
We're gonna get started.
That's really rare for STEM clubs. And I mean, even in our history, Julia is the second ever female lab lead, and to have that, it's pretty cool to be around.
There has been a very tangible change in RPL's culture from when I was a freshman to now. My class was primarily female at the beginning. I'm the only one out of that group who is still here now. A lot of it can be directly attributed to how we were treated in the organization, where it just doesn't feel great being a freshman woman who's breaking your back, trying to get involved, trying to learn everything, and it seems like the upperclassmen really only know you as the person who so-and-so has a huge crush on, and being talked about in that light rather than, oh, that's the freshman that stayed the entire 24 hours for our 8-inch test wind. I would like to think I put in even more work when I noticed that was happening. Looking back on it now, I would say there's really no amount of work that you can do to outwork that, and it's not your fault. It's never the person's fault for being thought of as just that freshman girl. A big reason why I wanted to stick around was I saw the opportunity that just being in the room would give other people. I don't know that I've changed it all that much, but I would like to think that I've made it more comfortable for a more diverse group of people to get involved. That was, at the end of the day, why I didn't just up and quit when I was asked to be lab lead, just kind of helping shift that mindset of where women can be involved in RPL.
There, and then simulations. The last but not least, Will is going to be pulling lots of wind files pretty much on the hour as we get them. Cool, okay.
I don't remember who said it exactly, but it's, these rockets are kind of like a testament to what people are capable of achieving. We've all worked up to this point. I kind of like to think of Spaceport America as the line between heaven and earth right now. This is pretty much where we go to send things into space, and we've earned this right, so.
The stakes for launching out of Spaceport versus somewhere like Mojave Desert or anywhere local, the stakes definitely get a lot higher when you have to go out somewhere this far. When you go up higher, it's always going to be higher risk, and especially for us right now, Fireball is kind of our attempt to get back on a good path with doing space shots and eventually getting to this larger goal of being a space program. So there's definitely a lot on the line because it is right next to White Sands Missile Range. That does mean that there's a big military presence. The biggest thing, honestly, that's concerning me right now is avionics. Some of our avionics cars are not here. That's because we have members coding while they're in the car, not while they're driving, but at the end of the day, avionics is what controls the launch's success.
So this is Hamster. This is like the avionics communication system. So this is how we kind of record and get sent the data for the altitude, velocity, acceleration of our rocket. We have our ground stations, which have antennas and like receiving equipment.
I can't hear you. Get fucked.
That have all been made in-house. And what they do is transmit packets towards the rocket. Packets are just units of information.
Lefty, you know, Lucy.
This is why I was chosen to be up
Lefty
here.
Lucy.
You're doing the wrong left.
Left? Lefty Lucy.
You're facing the wrong way, my guy.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Oh, my God. Please.
How many of the ring trend is electric?
Like two.
How many? Do we have five, right?
Yeah. We're in for a long night. Okay.
Do you think there's a high chance that the launch will get postponed?
No.
You guys think you can do it all?
Yeah. I'm confident.
Whenever I describe RPL to people, I'm afraid that I sound crazy, because this is like pretty much all I work on now. I mean, before this year, I was kind of like aimless. I mean, I wanted to do engineering, but then I joined RPL, and it's like the reason why I go to USC now at this point is because I want to go to RPL. There is no other organization, like probably in the history of humanity, that has, just on the scale of 20-year-olds sending rockets to space, like we are kind of on that kind of cutting edge. It really makes me feel like I myself can do anything.
There's something about this club. It got me and it got all of the people around you that we could be doing more fun things with our lives probably. We could be going to parties, but there's something about this that just gets you.
Lab's legacy is something that's really important to me. It's a storied history of so many different alumni trying really, really hard tasks, failing miserably at them, but picking themselves back up. And one of Fireball's goals, again, is being able to pass down knowledge. So it's a significant step in getting back to space and getting back to our founding mission, space or nothing.
Wow.
This is a very high scale launch, and there's a lot on the line, and I think we're all experiencing the fact that we've never done something of this scale before. Yeah, I mean, it's what, a little past midnight?
Bro, we're not sleeping, right?
Yeah.
We're not sleeping.
The winds that we're pulling currently are pretty powerful. We had pulled other wind models within the last couple weeks, and they were looking much more tame, much more normal to what we generally expect for this time of year. But every hour as we're pulling new files, it's been looking almost worse and worse, to be honest.
We're behind schedule by a good amount.
It's on the way. Over.
And avionics is now in their good state.
Over.
We're still waiting on avionics. Over. She said 2 to 4 more minutes.
Oh. Julia, update. The issue's worse than I thought.
The jet stream winds, which are the winds at like about 15,000 feet up, are much more powerful than we expected. And that means that they're blowing our rocket basically directly at White Sands missile range.
Zero, zero, zero.
Oh, that's probably fine. We're not an arm.
Yeah, no, that's not why that okay, happened. Okay.
All right, Lena, we're good. We're good.
Lena,
do you have an update on nominal avionics behavior and go for flight? Over.
Avionics is nominal. Over.
Copy that.
a.m. April 1st, our launch day. About half of us haven't slept at all. The other half has slept very little due to complications and issues arising. We've had to push through the night to make sure we actually hit our launch time. Earlier, or a few hours ago, we really weren't sure what this launch was going to look like, but it looks like things are coming together, so.
You are about to receive the vehicle in about 5 minutes.
It's been a long night.
It's long as hell too. My God.
It's been, we've been here for 24 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on.
Launch of the University of Southern California Rocket Propulsion Laboratory's rocket Fireball. We are now beginning our go halt checks. If there is any uncertainty or problem regarding the vehicle or the launch, please call halt. Deep is recovery go.
Recovery is go, over.
Abby, is the rail go?
Go, over.
Jess, please check the continuity of the igniter. Is the igniter a go?
Igniter is go, over.
Will, is the weather a go? Over.
Weather is a go. Over.
Lena, are avionics go?
Avionics are go. Over.
We are go for launch. We are currently at T-minus 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition. So what's next for USC RPL? Hopefully we will be going to space next year.
Fireball.
Conquered, or should I say I saw I conquered, I came. This little chico on fire, he no lie. Well, y'all slipping, he's running the game.